prompted you to start Jenom in 2011?
My boyfriend, actually. He's Turkish, which is where the name Jenom comes from. It's his nickname for me. It means sweetheart. And I was working for Anthropology as a store manager, and I loved it, but I was just getting, you know, a little down on myself because I would walk around and look at all these beautiful clothes and feel like I was missing out on, you know, something that I really loved to do. And he basically said, you don't have a choice and you're gonna do this, so why don't you just make a collection and, you know, I'll be supportive. And I did. It sold and it did well. And I kept going and left Anthropology, and that was it.
Yeah, that's awesome. So that's where the name came from, is his nickname for you. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
I was wondering, yeah.
And it literally translates to my love, my heart, my soul.
So how would you describe the whole aesthetic of your brand?
I would describe it as bohemian luxury. You know, I'm very much like a hippie at heart, but I also like the finer things in life, and I'm a foodie, and I like nice wine, and I appreciate the finer things, and I think that there's a way that there's something missing in the market between high-end fashion and bohemian chic. I thought I could do some great bohemian silhouettes and make them very easy to throw on, but make them with really great fabrications that are more classic and can last a little bit longer.
Yeah, and so your fabrications, I know, are reclaimed. Mm-hmm. So talk a little bit about that and how that came about.
So I use one of the heaviest weights on the market. It's not sheer, it's totally opaque silk charmeuse. When it's dyed, the mat really gives this great depth to the fabric and becomes totally washable. So it gives a new sort of life to the fabric and a unique look that you're not gonna find in a dry clean only piece.
Right, right, that's awesome.
Every time I dye something, it turns out different.
Yeah.
So really, you know, the thing that inspired me about doing the Indio collection was, you know, looking out here and seeing a beautiful sunset one day and wanting to mimic that and thinking, wouldn't that be great if that was printed on silk? And then I realized, like, I could actually dye that. There's some great oranges and a little blue in there, and I could do this great sort of landscaping dye. And I experimented a lot until I found one color, and then sort of kept adding on different color combinations.
That's awesome.
So it's, you know, each one is inspired by a different time of day. So you have, you know, twilight, midnight, sunset, sunrise, dusk. Uh-huh. And because they're each different, you know, I tell all my customers, you know, if you order dusk, you're gonna get something that's that time of day.
Yeah.
You're not necessarily gonna get something that looks like the sample, because they all end up completely unique. Some will have more blues and some will have more browns, and it's really what's, you know, beautiful about each piece.
Yeah, I mean, every sunset or sky is unique, so
exactly.
That's really cool that exactly. It kind of reflects into each piece, you know?
Exactly. One of the first pieces that I designed in the collection is called the pullover.
Uh-huh.
And it's basically just an oversized shirt.
I love it.
With little baseball sides so that it's got a little bit of flirt, you know,
that's
when you wear
cool.
It kind of comes up on the side
yeah.
And shows off a little leg.
How about the necklace? Does that have a story behind it?
This is actually a designer that I just befriended on Instagram. Mm-hmm. And I just fell in love with her aesthetic. It's sort of whimsical and
yeah.
Bohemian and all very handcrafted, and I think it's a great pair. This piece I originally designed for fall.
Uh-huh.
And you know, the people wanted it really badly, so I, you know, hurried up and made the production.
Yeah.
Because they wanted to wear this great little chiffon piece over a bathing suit.
That's cool. It's cool because you could wear it like as a dress with a slip underneath and
absolutely.
Like, yeah.
I mean, I designed it personally that I would wear it with, you know, a little crop tank and high-waisted jeans.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, wear it, you know, more for a night out. And then it really was my buyers that were telling me that they wanted it as a swimsuit cover-up.
Yeah.
Like, oh, that's such a good idea. Cause most of us are heaving through corrupted lungs. Setting fire to this is one of my favorite things in the whole collection. It's called the Indio Tent Maxi.
I love that. It's just so awesome.
And this is the sunset color, so you can see, you know, it's got the bright orange colors that you see in the LA sunsets.
Yeah.
Great pockets on the side. So much
fabric. I didn't know this one had pockets.
Yeah, it's got great little
hidden pockets.
All girls love pockets.
I love pockets.
Yeah. Something about a pocket makes you feel like a little girl, mm-hmm. You know? And of course, you know, you cannot help but feel super glamorous when you have 4 yards of silk charmeuse, you know, just covering you.
Oh my gosh.
And satin on the inside feels like lingerie.
Yeah.
And I just absolutely love this dress.
I love that. So good.
Thank you.
That one's perfect. So what about a prized possession?
My prized possession would be something that my grandmother gave me. Mm-hmm. And I'm not like a big designer person.
Yeah.
You know, I love just really special pieces. But this Hermes bag has such a great story behind it. She, you know, you've seen Mad Men, right?
Mm-hmm.
So she was sort of the Joan.
Okay.
A Beverly Hills agency.
Yeah.
And she had all of these men that would send her gifts because they just thought she was so charming and she was really good at her job. But it was one of her prized possessions and now it's mine.
So I know you do a lot of trunk shows and you can really get yourself out there that way. Is that a really good way for you to grow the brand?
Yeah, I think that you know, I believe that the more people you can reach, the better. And obviously that's, social media is such a huge part of promoting your brand. Mm-hmm. But, and don't want to lose that one-on-one because that really kind of brings it all full circle.
If they don't get an opportunity to touch the fabrics and to know who the designer is, they're missing an element of the brand.
Yeah.
So I love to support retailers that support me. And it's sort of like the old way of starting a rock band. It's like you have to go on tour,
right?
And you have to meet your fans, and each person is so important. So to be able to have the opportunity and meet customers and really interact with them is really important.
Yeah, it's really rewarding, and it's great to have that one-on-one connection, you know?
Absolutely.
For sure. What are some things you've learned along the way that have just been really helpful and that you even kind of use as a lesson in everyday business now as you move forward?
I would say just to make it go right is the biggest thing. And I tell that to my team every day. It's like, there's gonna be problems,
yes.
You know? When you're manufacturing something, there's always problems. So, you know, you can't look at a problem or look at a mistake and cave into yourself. You have to look at it and go, okay, I'm just gonna make that go right. And what can we do? And there's always a solution to every problem. And that's how I've been able to, you know, keep the business going and really get to the point where, you know, I'm growing a great brand.